All right, so what happens when we create a class and nothing happens is nothing happens. When you want to run a function as soon as the animal is created or as soon as it's instantiated here, we can have a function run when this is called, basically. And in different programming languages, it's done a different way. In Python, it's the init method. In C++ and other C languages, it's just the class name again. But in JavaScript, it's just called constructor. So let's go ahead and start using this. Constructor will be run every single time that we create an animal. So in this constructor, I'm just going to console log created animal. And then I'm going to save it and refresh. And you see, I don't even have to call that constructor method. It calls itself as soon as the animal is created. Now I'm also going to create a fish. So var fish equals new animal. And right now, both of these instantiations look the same, and they are, because they're just using a different variable name for it. So in order to make this more unique, we're going to start passing parameters into the constructor. And this is just done like any other method call where you pass parameters in, except there's one difference. You may think that you're going to be passing the parameters into the class, but you're not. When you write out the instantiation of a class, you put these brackets here, and basically whatever's in here goes to the constructor method. So if we're going to pass in name, height and weight, because these are all properties that all animals have, then in the instantiation here, I'm going to say the dog's name is Fido. His height is 25 inches and his weight is 90 pounds. So he's a very short, heavy dog. And then the fish, let's say his name is Goldie. I've never had a fish, so I don't know the standard height and weight. I'm going to say 2 inches, and his weight is going to be 0.02 pounds. I'm not sure. Anyway, that's what we're passing in, so that's that's his height and weight. Not sure if that's realistic or not, that's all. So, when I save this, I'm going to actually change the console log that runs in the constructor so that we can see the data that's coming in. So, for right now, I'm just going to make it say create an animal named, and then the name that we pass in there. So, I'm going to save it and refresh it. And as you can see, it uses the parameter name as we've told it to do. So you can see that the parameters are being passed from the class instantiation right into the constructor. And that's how that works. Now, let's say we want to get the length of their name. So I'm going to create a class method, or an instance method, rather, that's called how long is, or rather, name length. And this is going to be a problem because we can't access the name here. Let's go ahead and try to return name.length. Save this. And down here on the dog object, I'm going to call it console log dog dot name length. Whoops. There we go. I'm gonna save it and I'm gonna run it. And we know that the length of the dog's name is 4, not 0. So what's actually happening here is even though we passed these values into the constructor, they're not yet usable by the entire object. They're only usable right now within the constructor. Now, to declare instance variables or variables that any method can be used or can use it, we need to use the this keyword. Now, this refers to the object itself. So it refers to dog and fish, the two different objects that are created here. So this dot name equals name. This dot height equals height, and this dot weight equals weight. So we're taking these parameters that are only usable in the constructor, and we're creating properties of the object itself. So now the object has a name, the object has a height. So we can use that in other methods. So I just changed this to this.name.length. Now let's go ahead and save this and run it again, and now you will see that Fido's name is 4 characters long. If I run it on fish instead, it's going to return 6. Now, we can also define static variables. So these are going to be unique for each object created from this class. Each object is going to have its own name, height, and width, or weight. And that's just the way that works, or rather, that's the way that this works. You can create a variable that is going to be instantiated for this class that will not depend, or it won't be unique to a given object. It will always be the same. So, in this case, what variable could I attach to that? That would be the same for all animals. I know. So I'm going to say animal, and this is outside of the class, by the way. I'm going to say animal dot planet equals Earth. So now what this does is by doing this outside of the class, it doesn't matter if this or this is created. Dog.planet is going to be Earth, and so is fish.planet. So let's print out dog.planet. Save and refresh, and it is undefined. So let me have a look here. Let me just print out dog. Let's inspect it a bit. Save, refresh. All right. So let me do some inspecting here. Animal planet is Earth. So dog.planet is undefined. Oh, sorry, yes. All right, so to call class level variables instead of instance variables, to access the dog's name, we would do this, and that would print out Fido. To access variables that are not unique or not instance variables, but they're class variables, we would access that by doing the object name dot constructor dot whatever the variable is we want. So in this case, it's planet. So I'm going to save this and refresh, and we have Earth. And then we can change this to fish, and save, and refresh, and it still prints out Earth. And that is because, again, we've created a class-level variable, which is not unique to instances of the class, whereas anything you define with the this keyword is unique to that. So, that was a bit to sink in. I hope you guys had an easy time understanding that. This is one of the things that when I was starting with object-oriented programming, and maybe I just didn't have the right information, but this confused me a bit, constructors and instance variables and class variables. So hopefully I explained that well. Let me know if I did or I didn't, or if you want any other information or have any questions about this.